Hello, and welcome back, everyone. AnthWolf here with even more Star Wars The Old Republic, playing as our Sith Sorcerer Veriia. Where we last left off, we had just returned to the planet of Korriban to maybe select a new Sith apprentice to complement Ashara here on board our Fury Interceptor, but we can't select one just as yet. Overseer Harkon is putting them through their paces, and has recommended we come back and check on their progress at some point in the future. But when we came back to the Fury, apparently the Jedi had taken some Sith artifacts on a transport that was shot down maybe a year ago. Well, maybe not shot down, it got lost over half a year ago. And since then there have been rumors of something happening on the planet, people hearing voices. So we're going to go investigate. Now, where is Hoth again? The Outer Rim, I guess? Indeed. There we are. Few life forms can survive on the ice planet Hoth. Between its sub-zero surface temperatures, shearing winds, and frequent whiteouts, the environment should be considered extremely hostile, even to properly outfitted individuals. Mechanical equipment and communications technology are prone to freeze and malfunction as well, making any minor setback potentially lethal. During the war between Republic and Empire, the Hoth system was a site of a major fleet battle. This resulted in a large number of starships falling in the Hoth's gravity well and crashing on the planet's surface. These derelict ships have become the base of operations for a large group of pirates, as well as a center of dispute between Republic and Imperial forces. Okay, let's travel to the world. Goodbye, Korriban. We hardly knew you.
I hope you found some more information on this ghost business, Andronicus.
Look, I've been doing some digging around, and by all accounts, this stuff is more messed up than Tatooine. Pirates run this place, though the Empire and the Republic have dared to move in of late. Still, ships don't land here. The cold is part of it, but there are other rumors. The kind you'd ignore if you had sense.
Fortunately, I'm not interested in sense. Only ghosts. What do these rumors say?
There was a light freighter out of Yavin 4, Star Runner. Disappeared over this place. Reported some strange happenings before it did. It was a smuggler vessel, loaded full of ancient junk from Yavin's tombs. If I wanted to catch a ghost, I'd start asking after that ship.
Thank you, Andronicus. Kemval, or is it Zash? Let's go.
Hollow Chatter says the Empire's operating on this ice block, so you might try using your new Lord of the Sith authority. Careful, though. Place is crawling with pirates, and they aren't all as nice as me.
Yeah, at least you're honest about trying to stab us in the back. We'll take Kemval because we also need to recover Tulak Hord bones. Bloody hell. That's hard to say for some reason. It's too early in the morning. Well, afternoon. I was up till about 5 a.m, so it's morning for me. Yeah, Kemval is having visions now of people desecrating Tulak Hord's tomb, and that his bones have been taken to this world of Hoth. Or it could be employed by Zash, of course. Before we look into the Star Runner and the bones of Tulak Hord, we will assist the Imperial forces like we did on Taris. We'll see how we can push back probably the Republic and the pirates. And similar to Taris again, I think we're going to be docking with an orbital station and taking a shuttle down to the planet's surface. I don't think there are any starports on Hoth itself. Kemval.
Of course.
Nundin Quibans.
Hello, Kel. We are well synced to level 42. Kelm, you can be... I'd be a damage dealer. Why not? Looks like Ensign Ryle would like to have a word with us. Ah, he begins the story arc. Okay.
Welcome to the Adama Space Station, my lord. I'm Ensign Rail. I gather this visit is because you'll be traveling through to the surface of Hoth.
I did not come here to share my plans with ensigns.
I'm dreadfully sorry, my lord. I was assigned to assist you upon your arrival. I'll be scanning you so I can customize your cold weather equipment. Then I'll arrange your briefing. There we are. As you're on the VIP list, Lieutenant Halpern will brief you. He's in the theater. Good day.
And here's the briefing officer, Lieutenant Halpern. How can we help?
That's Ancient. A lord is present. At ease. Let's get this started. Ostensibly, the conflict on Hoth is over salvage from a battle that happened above the planet. In reality, it is our trap for the Republic.
I hadn't heard anything about a trap on Hoth. Explain.
The fight with the Republic has lasted for years now. The objective on Hoth is not to end the battle, but to sustain it. We want our forces small and mobile, and while the Republic keeps chasing victory, we bleed them dry of personnel and equipment.
The strategy seems sound. How will it change what I do?
It means we will rely heavily on small unit groups, such as yourself, to cause damage and withdraw. Pitched battles are lost battles.
My lord, forgive the interruption. I brought your cold weather equipment.
We were just finishing, Ensign.
This should keep your core body temperature up. When you're ready, report to a pilot in the shuttle bay for transport to the planet.
Colonel Vannis at Dorn Base will be waiting for you. Good luck down there.
Okay, and we did get some cold weather equipment. Increases elemental resistance by 10% for 60 minutes. Okay. You don't need to use it on the planet's surface. I don't think you get a debuff. I'm not sure if you ever did get a debuff here on Hoth. Maybe when the game was originally released. I never came to Hoth, I wasn't that far enough in the game to tell you, to be perfectly honest. Oh, hello.
The planet awaits, my lord. Commander Triton will want to meet with you.
My briefing said I was to meet a Colonel Vannis.
I don't know anything about that. Commander Triton's the one listed as in charge now. I'm sure he can fill you in on the story. I need to de-ice the shuttle here.
Interesting. So between us leaving the orbital station and coming down to Dorn Base, there's been a change in command. A little bit awkward. Lore object telling us about the Chiss, which is these blue-skinned people. Another race who are working with the Empire. Just give it a moment, it looks like not everyone is loading in. There you go. Commander Triton, and we have Captain Udras.
Your advice boils down to doing nothing, and that I cannot do.
Sir, I respect your bravery, but if you see this through personally, you will be dead. And whose leadership will we have then? My lord, we're glad you've arrived. May I introduce Commander Triton, and myself, a humble captain, corps name Udris.
Lieutenant Halpin sent word you would be coming, and we've never had greater need of you.
Colonel Vannis, the commander of this base, is missing. We fear he's dead, along with all the most experienced men from this base.
Not many non-humans have the ear of a base commander.
Yes, well, my influence is entirely up to Commander Triton.
Our Chiss allies have valuable knowledge of the planet. Udris is advising me during this emergency.
An emergency that grows more dire every moment the Colonel is missing. This was the distress call we received.
Scout 1 to Dorn base! Heavy casualties! Taking heavy casualties! We're under attack! We can't see the...
Graphic.
What on this world could take out an armed group of officers?
Besides the Republic, there are Wampers, pirates. Mostly aliens unafraid of the Empire.
But we can't simply cower in our base when the mission is to damage and exhaust the Republic.
And our men can't do it. Commander, this visit is a gift to us from fate.
Sure, we can look into that for you.
Whoever is behind this will be nothing but a blot on the snow.
Indeed. I have heard of the power of Sith. I only hope that you have not come too late. Our best case scenario is that Colonel Vannis' communications tipped off the Republic, and he's gone quiet.
But if I were out in that cold, I'd have called for a rescue. If you can find the Colonel, everyone on this base is in your debt.
Okay, so we get a look into where the Colonel may be. So welcome to Dorn Base, everyone. It has, obviously, the command center here on the lower level. We have a cantina where we can speak to Sergeant Lauren about looking for the Star Runner that came out of Yavin 4, but first things first, let's head out into the Icefall Plains. There's two ways up to the upper level, two elevators here. It's coming down slowly but surely. Welcome to the outside of Hoth itself, on the planet's surface. Indeed, Calm. And we have some Tauntauns. Animal Mount Vendor. You can buy a Mountain Tauntaun for 20 Tauntaun Domestication Data. Which could cost you, what, 2 million? Or you could lure out a protective Tauntaun when fed to a fawn. Defend a nest to gain domestication data. Okay, so you could gain data for using the lure, or you could just buy the data itself. So where do we need to go? Go a bit to the east. Oh, there we go. Now, there are various different forms of wildlife here on Hoth itself, and of course we have the pirates, the Republic troops, and the Republic have a group of special forces training their people. Ah, and there they are themselves, the Talz. Yes, the Talz. They are an alien race teaching the Republic here guerrilla tactics. There's a bonus to defeat 20 Tal forces here. Yeah. There is a, I think there is at least a heroic mission to deal with the Talz. Prevent them from training the Republic any more of their tactics and how to survive in this cold weather. The bonus complete, and now let's just find the good Colonel Vanis. Now he's being held prisoner here. Through this chamber. Oh. Looks like he's dead. Unfortunate. Well, let's report our discovery to the new commander of Dorn Base, I guess. Just quick travel back to the cantina, because that's the one on the lower level.
I found Colonel Vanis. He was dead. Murdered by Republic Talz.
Talz. That would make sense. Cold adapted, Republic aligned. I've not killed their kind before. What about you, Commander?
What? Yes, of course.
The base awaits your orders, Commander.
We are having deep morale issues in the forward outpost. I must show them that we can triumph without Colonel Vanis. Now is the time for reprisals. These chittering animals will not get away with this. I want 10 of the Republic to suffer for every one of ours dead. I want every last Talz wiped out, their heads on sticks out in the frost.
Anything you'd like to add?
The main thrust of the plan is sensible, but given our limited knowledge, I suggest the plan be refined before use. A covert action is advisable, or we'll end up wiping out one group and causing the rest to go into hiding. I have data arrays we could install in their communications link. If we did that, we could locate and estimate their numbers before we hit them.
Interesting. I do like that idea. I wouldn't want them to go into hiding. Sure, we'll take that idea, actually.
They weren't carrying handheld comms. They've probably got way stations. I can bug those.
This sounds plausible. As much as I hate to admit it, Udris is usually right about these things.
Commander! Come in, Commander!
Go ahead, Scout 5.
We found a nest of Talz on the ice lake. Too many to engage. Transmitting coordinates now.
Our luck is changing. If we can get those arrays into whatever they're using for communications, we'll soon know what we need.
When you're done, report to the forward outpost. It's closer to the lake, and the men there can see your success in person.
Sounds like a plan. So where's this? Okay, between Icefall Plains and High Mount Ridge. Out we go, right, to the east once again. Oh, we've got the Talz attention again. They're hiding in the snow, you'll notice that. Keep forgetting, they're like the sand people on Tatooine, they'll just spring up out of nowhere, trying to ambush you. So looks like we're going to the lake. Oh, don't mind me, oh hell, yeah. They used some sort of sedative attack on me and stunned me in place. Thankfully they didn't knock me off my speeder. Frostbite Lake. Is there a bonus here? Let's find out. There is not. Okay. So don't look at me, I'm not doing anything suspicious. Sith Marauder. Looks like they're doing the similar quest. And one more communications array. Excellent. Now we need to go to the forward bunker, which is this way. We can report our success without going back to Dorn base. Yeah, both the Republic and the Imperial forces have these dugout emplacements, protected by pretty large turbo lasers, actually. As we proceed through, obviously, the world of Hoth itself. See, we as member of the Sith Empire traveling through, like, the southern paths through High Mount Ridge, the Glacial Fissure, and the Starship Graveyard, whereas a member of the Republic starts, I think, in maybe the Tundra? And travels along the upper paths through Hoth itself.
Good to hear from you. We've been receiving the feed from the data arrays, and what we've learned is quite interesting. We had assumed there were one, perhaps two groups of Talz out there. We found six. Had we attacked earlier, we would have gotten one group and the other five would have gone to ground.
Now that we've tracked them, it is time to exterminate them.
Commander Triton and I believe we have the answer.
The good part is we know how many Talz there are. The bad part is we don't have enough forces to hit all six groups at once. We have devised a plan to put the Talz in position for a killing blow. Their supplies, weapons, medical equipment, and the high-calorie food they require, all of it is stored in one central location. They may be adapted to the cold, but without their supplies, they wouldn't last a week. So we will destroy their cache.
They will choose between retreating home or starvation.
That, or the one other option that we think the more likely.
If I were them, and suddenly without food, I would raid this base. So we will amplify our defenses here and spring the trap shut. Unfortunately, getting at their supplies may be difficult. They are in a series of ice caves overrun by Wampers.
The more challenging, the better.
If that is the case, I suggest an alternative. We are desperately short on supplies here. If you could bring back all you find, it could make a valuable difference.
But we'd need over 100 kilos of food alone. How would anyone carry that and still fight?
Oh. Well, I know we're thin as sticks, but Kemval here's got a lot of muscles.
You'd be surprised how much I can carry.
Daring, my lord. I hope you're making the right call. Take anything of theirs that gives them aid or comfort. Make them come crawling. Let them know who the masters of this miserable world are.
Okay. So where do we need to go now? Oh, okay. There was a cave next to the Frostbite Lake. Recover the Talz food, collect their medical supplies, and recover their ordnance. Okay, sounds like fun. And if we're in time, the Sith Marauder may have some use. And she could cut a path for us. It's all Sith politics. But this time I'll be using another player character if I'm lucky. Yep. Good, good. I'll just watch. Nah, come on, we'll help out. I could be a bit of a dick. But we'll help out. Is there a bonus to defeat some of the Wampa? I can't remember. Let's find out. Ah, there is. Okay. Remember Wampa's, of course, from Empire Strikes Back. Play with the Wampas while the Marauder has a bit of fun with the Talz base of operations. Down here. Is there anything? Oh. Racks of bombs. I'll take those. Thank you. So that's the ordnance. Need medical supplies and food now. Lightsaber away. There we go. Here's the medical supplies. Oh, and here's the food. Handy. Perfect. Now where to report to Captain Triton? Back at the Holo Terminal. Okay. Let's quick travel back to the forward bunker.
Your cargo, Captain Udras. In one piece, as am I.
Yes, my lord. You'll be pleased to know that we have kept up our end of the plan.
The base is prepared for war. We have security fields, sensors, anti-personnel guns. We'll obliterate any Talz that dares approach.
Commander! Commander! There's reports of a Talz attack.
Excellent. What wing are they headed for?
No wing, sir. They're at the power station. They're overrunning the guards. They brought bombs.
These Talz have no fear. Even when their army is at its last breath, they want to take us down with them.
If they kill the power station, we'll have no heat. We'll have to evacuate, or we won't last past nightfall.
I'll be there in but a moment.
I'll call for reinforcements from Ademus Orbital. They should be able to land within the hour. Just get to that power station, and quickly.
As Udras said, they have no fear. So you gotta admire a persistent enemy. To the overrun power station. I wonder if that's what it was called. Or it's literally overrun, which would probably be the more logical answer. Giant bumper. Okay, so yeah, we're quite close to the power plant here. Imperial assault droids have been destroyed. Oh, there's a transport being brought down. Oh, hello. Dotu Mubacha, a droid engineer. Can we take you down? I don't know. Let's find out. I like our force regeneration. Definitely coming in handy. Barely eating into our force supply right now. Ah. go. See, not as if we get anything special for defeating him, but he's a champion of the Republic. We may as well bring him low. Now continue onwards to the power station. Seems pretty straightforward. Planting bombs. We probably don't want to use force lightning. We might set off the bombs prematurely. It won't, but we'll pretend. We'll pretend for a moment like it would. Former slave, Lord of the Sith, bomb disposal expert. I can do everything. Complete. Let's heal ourselves up slightly, taking a little bit of punishment. Disabled. Maybe one more to go. Nice big empty room. If this was any other game, like an RPG, this would be a boss battle room. But wait, it is an RPG. The Talz Sergeant. God, you're ugly up close. Well, that's specious of me.
Killing you will be such fun.
Hmm.
So where's this champion of yours? Oh. Ask and ye shall receive. Oh, reinforcements. As late as ever.
Lieutenant Oron reporting in, my lord. Our company is on the ground and we have secured the perimeter.
You couldn't have arrived while I was fighting an army.
I'm sorry, my lord. We were ensuring no Talz escaped the trap. We'll finish up here. If you return to Dorn base, Commander Triton will no doubt want to congratulate you in person.
At least he had an excuse. Right. Yeah, let's travel back to the cantina.
Say the Sith held off the entire Talz force single-handed.
It sounds incredible to be sure, but here, I'll let you talk directly. My lord, we cannot express our gratitude. May I introduce Moff Brainor, overseer of the Hoth system, among others?
I am surprised you'd take an interest in this humble base.
Your base is key to our activities on Hoth, and if not for you, it would have been lost. It is for that reason I ask you your opinion. Would you say Commander Triton or Chiss Captain Udris was more instrumental in the base's defense?
No, it's probably a dark side answer to choose Commander Triton because he's human, naturally. Whereas choosing the Chiss Captain because he's an alien and the Sith Empire hates aliens would be the light side option. But be fair, the Chiss Captain's had the better ideas. And we are also non-human, so yeah, nice to see another alien getting ahead.
Captain Udras's advice formed most of our key strategies. We relied on him heavily.
That is as I expected. Very well. Captain Udras, you are now Colonel Udras. I am putting the base's welfare in your hands until further notice.
It seems you have broken down a few barriers, Colonel Udras.
I thank you. This is unprecedented. You do me great honor, Moff Brainor. I will have the base at inspection quality immediately.
Sir, if I might ask, do you think the enlisted men will have a problem taking orders from Colonel Udras?
You mean, will they refuse orders from a Chiss? They will at first. Then they will be made examples.
You could demonstrate your commitment by helping win the men over.
That is an excellent idea. I will begin immediately. Thank you, Moff Brainor. Colonel Udras.
That will be all.
Well, that went better than expected.
I suppose we should be happy we don't have pirate problems here.
He's referring to another security failure. Captain Revar at Leth Outpost lost a reactor substation to the White Moor pirates. We have asked much of you, but Captain Revar has not. And his soldiers desperately need relief at the Leth Outpost. If you have the time, look in on them.
Subtle hint, if you want to continue the story arc here in Hoth, go find Captain Revar. I can take a hint. Oh, we missed the elevator. Okay. We'll get back up to the planet's surface. And then we will continue. Well, I'll break the video. And then we'll be heading over to High Mount Ridge. We'll take the scenic view, we may as well. And we'll see how we can assist Captain Revar on his... What his troops need, basically. Apparently they require relief. They've lost another power station there. plenty of miscellaneous goods to sell. I'll do that between videos. Yeah, I'll break this video here. This, of course, has been AnthWolf playing Star Wars The Old Republic, playing as our Sith Inquisitor. As I say, when we come back, we'll continue to help Imperial efforts here on Hoth. We may assist Kemval retrieve Tulak Hord's bones if we're passing by them. If not, we'll wait until we start doing our own personal interests here on the planet. But we'll wait and see what happens. I'll see you all next time. Until then, bye-bye now.